Hey, what's up? It's Jared with State of Tech, and today I'm here for scientific purposes, basically. I have a MacBook Pro, and I've really been messing around with these eGPUs, trying different things, trying to see if I can get the kind of performance out of my MacBook Pro that I'm able to get out of like a tower, like a full computer, whether it be a PC or maybe even a more powerful Mac. So what originally started kind of this experimentation is that I had a eGPU for my MacBook Pro. So this is my MacBook Pro 2018 edition. This is the i9. It's the fully maxed out edition, except for the hard drive. I only went with 1 terabyte on that. And these here are eGPUs from Gigabyte. These are RX 580 eGPUs. They come as a kit already put together with a cool little carrying case, and they're relatively small. Now, prior to this, I had a eGPU that was a Razer Core version 2. Great eGPU, very well built, but it was just a little big. And being on my desk, I just wanted something smaller. And so I thought, well, I'll give these a try just to see if there were any performance difference. And I was able to determine that there was very, very little performance difference between the Razer Core. You would think maybe the Razer Core, because it's bigger and you can fit a, this is just like a single fan GPU. It's not a very big GPU, that maybe the bigger of the GPUs would perform better. And I was only really able to get a couple of seconds of better performance out of the Razer. And that could go either way. That's not even definitive. So what really got me thinking was when I took one of these, I got one of these and I plugged it in to my MacBook Pro along with the other eGPU. Now, I had read online in a forum that the MacBook Pro will support up to 4 GPUs being plugged into it. And I thought to myself, well, why would they do that unless there was a purpose for performance, like maybe either with gaming or with video editing? And so for me, video editing really is what I would care about most. And so we're going to do some tests today. Now, I have the MacBook Pro sitting here. I have a project that's on my hard drive, and I used this project as a kind of a benchmark. It's not a very long project, but I know that the results are going to speak for themselves. So I'm going to go ahead and open up this project, which this is actually going to be a little different of a test for me, because the last time that I ran this test was about a week ago. And Adobe dropped their 2019 edition of their software, of their Creative Cloud. And there's actually even been some improvements made in Premiere Pro for the Mac specifically. I mean, they said there's lots of performance boosts that they've made. And I've noticed this. I've edited a couple of projects earlier this week, and I can tell that there is some performance benefits to upgrading to the latest version, the 2019 edition. So I'm going to go ahead and kind of just get things set up here, and we're going to jump back in. We're going to start by running this test, rendering out this project, which is about 1:40 in length, and we're going to render that out just on the laptop itself with no power hooked up to it. Then we're going to hook power up to it. Then we're going to hook one eGPU up to it, 2 and then 3 eGPUs, and we're going to test this out and see what the difference is. Now, like I said earlier, it could support up to 4 eGPUs, but the reason that I'm only going to run 3 is because I still need one of my ports, one of my USB-C ports, to go to the monitor. I run this little adapter here, which is a USB-C to DisplayPort adapter to my monitor. I found that when I plugged in my monitor to the eGPU, that there was just weird performance issues and weird bugs with the system. When it came to disconnecting the eGPU from your Mac, there was weird issues there. And then of course, when I was rendering and doing things that required the performance of the eGPU, the performance was degraded because the eGPU had to also run the monitor. So my decision was I would rather run 3 eGPUs and have my monitor going out than have to use one of the eGPUs to power the monitor, because then you can disconnect all 3 eGPUs and unplug them even. And because your monitor is connected to a separate USB-C port, I haven't had any issues there. Who knows, maybe the MacBook Pro will have some updates later that will work the issues out of disconnecting an eGPU when the monitor is connected to it. But right now I find that running the monitor direct into the laptop, where the monitor is being powered by the internal processing, the internal GPU that the MacBook Pro has, is the best option. And then just using the eGPUs as power sources to increase performance. All right, so I'll be right back. We're gonna get set up here and start rendering out this project. Okay, so the first render just finished. That's under the MacBook Pro's power by itself without any power plugged into it. Again, it's a 1:40 footage, and it took 3:31 to render out. So that's quite a bit of time. Consider maybe rendering out a project that's 30 minutes long, and that's more than double the time almost. And so that's twice the amount of time that you're gonna have to wait for a 4K project to render out. So we're gonna go ahead and plug in our first eGPU over here. So I'm gonna plug that in like so, and now we have power actually going to the MacBook Pro as well, and the fan has just spun up a little bit there. I'm going to go ahead and open Media Encoder back up, and we're going to render out the exact same project but with one GPU. Let's check that out. Okay, so the first run with the first eGPU has finished. One of the interesting things that came as a change with Premiere Pro in the 2019 edition here is that the default in Media Encoder is set to GPU acceleration with Metal. That is, of course, Apple's framework or platform that they've developed for their own systems. That's something that's not available on PCs and even older Macs. But OpenCL is typically what we would use. If you're on a PC, you would use the CUDA cores of your device, whatever GPU it is that was in your system. But I had an interesting finding here, and that's with rendering out in Metal with one eGPU is actually a couple seconds slower than the MacBook Pro was, even unplugged with no power going through it. So using Metal as the acceleration, the renderer, 3:31 with the MacBook Pro unplugged, 3:33 with one eGPU plugged in. But what I did was go ahead and set it to OpenCL just to see what we're gonna get. And it's almost finished here. And I think this is where we're really gonna see the performance. I'm guessing that these GPUs are not optimized for Metal. They don't operate that way or something about them. That's something I'm definitely gonna have to research because I'm interested. Right now, this project just finished. So with OpenCL and one eGPU, let me go into the log and I'll make sure to show all of you the log as well. So the log shows 2:58. So that's that kind of performance that I was looking for. So I'm gonna notate that 2:58 on OpenCL. Because that matters. I mean, the renderer that you choose, that actually does matter. That's something that I am now finding out, and it's interesting information. So I'm gonna go ahead and reset this render project. I'm going to quit out of Media Encoder. We're going to plug in our next eGPU here. So we'll go ahead and plug that in. And that should start spinning up here in a second, and it will show now two eGPUs in that eGPU dropdown that's up in our menu bar. So I'm gonna go ahead and open Media Encoder back up. So what I'm gonna do for this test here is I'm gonna show you all of the results for both rendering out using Metal and using OpenCL. So that way we can kind of see the difference, because obviously using Metal by itself with the Mac with no eGPU is better than using one eGPU under Metal. Of course, if we go to OpenCL, then we save, what was that? We saved 33 seconds essentially there on a render that's only 1:40 long. So like I said before, imagine what that would be like on a project that's like a half hour long. So with two eGPUs, I'm gonna switch back to Metal. I'm going to render this out. So let's go ahead and clear that out. And we will render this file out here, hit start. And we'll see what kind of performance we get on Metal, and then I'll switch over to OpenCL. We'll render out with OpenCL. Then we'll move over to our third GPU and see exactly what we had happen. So I'm gonna go ahead and fast forward till we get through this next render, and I'll check back in with you. Okay, so the numbers are really starting to speak for themselves. Now with two eGPUs, we saw a little bit better time rendering out in metal with 3 minutes and 17 seconds, but that really wouldn't be that big of a jump considering you'd have to buy two eGPUs and you're looking at like, you know, $800 or $900 of an investment right there. But when switching to OpenCL, it jumped down to 2 minutes and 46 seconds. That's what I was seeing when I was doing this test initially with one of these Gigabyte eGPUs and the Razer Core GPU with the RX 580 that I had in it. So now we're gonna add in a third one. So we're gonna see if performance can just continue to stack. So I'm gonna take the USB-C cord for the third eGPU and we're gonna plug that in here. Now adding three eGPUs to my MacBook Pro. And of course, if I didn't have this hard drive plugged in over here, I could add a fourth and then just edit or use the screen of my MacBook Pro. But I do like to have that additional port there so that I could plug in an external monitor. So we have three GPUs plugged into the MacBook Pro now. That's pretty crazy. You know, I don't even do this with a normal PC because the performance doesn't actually improve that much when you start stacking GPUs in a PC. So let's go ahead and open Media Encoder back up. And after I get done with this test, I'm gonna go back and render out this project in OpenCL using the MacBook Pro with nothing plugged into it so that I can have that baseline OpenCL and metal. Remember, we started out with 3 minutes and 31 seconds on metal. Adding one eGPU, we actually lost a little bit of time, but adding a second eGPU, we got, about 10 seconds of an improvement on that 1 minute and 40 second file. And so now we're gonna test out three eGPUs. Because I want a big reveal at the end, I'm gonna start with metal as the renderer, and then I'll do OpenCL as the last test here with all of these GPUs. So I'll be back in a minute. Let's check it out. All right, so my testing is complete and the numbers are pretty interesting. So with the MacBook Pro unplugged, just to recap here, rendering out under metal, it was 3 minutes and 31 seconds. OpenCL was actually faster at 3 minutes and 26 seconds. I thought that since maybe Premiere listed metal as the first option now, that was actually gonna be faster, but it turned out that it wasn't. It was a little bit slower on this project. Then adding in those initial GPUs, we didn't see any real good performance gains except for OpenCL. We went from 3 minutes and 26 seconds, MacBook Pro only, to 2 minutes and 58 seconds. Then adding in another GPU, we got that down to 2 minutes and 46 seconds. So really only about 12 seconds of savings there. Not really that much under OpenCL. Obviously the metal numbers are not the numbers that we're really gonna be paying attention to because they're just higher numbers. But then when we added in the third GPU, the third eGPU, we dropped down to 2 minutes and 3 seconds under OpenCL. Keep in mind this file was this timeline was 1 minute and 40. And so 1 minute and 40 and it took 2 minutes and 3 seconds to render out. That's not too bad at all. Now, I typically would render out using my Threadripper PC that I built. My Threadripper PC has the first generation Threadripper 16 core 32 thread. It has 64 gigabytes of RAM. It has a 1080 Ti GPU in it and NVMe hard drives inside of it. It's an extremely fast computer, and that rendered out the project in 2 minutes and 13 seconds with the monitor connected. Now I say with the monitor connected because that 1080 Ti also had to power the monitor in order to render that out. When I disconnected the monitor and then just remoted into the computer, it actually rendered out that project in 2 minutes. So I think the whole moral of the story here is that rendering out on a Mac is very possible using Premiere Pro and having a lot of power and getting good render times. No more are the days where you have to go to a PC to get good render times. Now, granted, this is kind of a crazy setup here. By the time that you pay about $4,000 for a MacBook Pro like this, and then you pay $400 for each, so this is $1,200 in GPUs sitting right here, you've got quite a bit of money wound up in this project. However, you can always take your laptop disconnected from these, and go. You can also take one of these with you easily because they come with a cool little carrying case. However, with my PC, that is basically stationary. I'm not gonna pick up my whole tower and carry that around with me as I work, and then I need a monitor and a keyboard and a mouse and all that stuff, and it becomes quite a bit of a problem. So also, with the PC, I typically also would have a laptop. So I have about $4,000, about $4,200 wrapped up in that PC, not including a monitor. And then if you add in buying a laptop for maybe $2,000, you're still ending up with a lot of money wound up in computers. So I think what I'm trying to say here is that the MacBook Pro with eGPU support, and this is still early on, I'm sure there will be more optimizations to come as Apple adds more ability to connect different GPUs and whatnot, and these GPU manufacturers start officially supporting Mac OS, there will just be more and more performance gains there. But OpenCL, three GPUs connected to a MacBook Pro, outperformed my Threadripper PC that has a GTX 1080 Ti in it. And that is what's gonna make me sleep great tonight, because that's just such a cool thing to have happen in a world where Macs typically just don't perform well in Premiere Pro. Those days are over, and that was the job here that I was trying to achieve in plugging all of this stuff in. It makes me really interested to see what happened if I plug in a fourth eGPU, but I had to buy all of these myself. I'm not sponsored by anybody. Gigabyte did not send these to me, but I'm sure they're gonna be pretty impressed with the results that I had that I showed in this video. So thanks so much for checking out this video. If you are a Mac enthusiast and you like to edit video, Premiere Pro is once again something that you can use, and of course have your productivity back. Use your Mac, because you're not just gonna have to let it sit there and render out videos all day anymore. I'm super excited for that. So click on that subscribe button to this channel, give it a thumbs up. If you want some eGPUs, I've got links down in the description below for you. Clicking on those links and making your eGPU purchases would help support the channel here. Like I said, all of this stuff I purchase myself to test out and do all these trial runs myself, because science, right? So go ahead and click on those links and support our channel here on State of Tech. And I hope to see you back here soon. So click that subscribe, give us a like, and we'll see you back in the next one.